In the last few videos, I've gone over the process of electron transport from NADH to oxygen via complexes 1, 3, and 4. You may have been wondering what happened to complex 2 and how QH2 produced in the citric acid cycle fits into all this. This video addresses those questions. Complex 2 does exist, and it is the enzyme that catalyzes the citric acid cycle reaction converting succinate to fumarate. This is a redox reaction that reduces coenzyme Q to QH2. The QH2 produced is chemically identical to the QH2 produced by complex 1, and it will give its electrons to complex 3 as described in the previous video. So complex 2 represents another pathway through which electrons are removed from carbon during the citric acid cycle and transferred ultimately to molecular oxygen. Complex 2, or succinate dehydrogenase, is shown in more detail here. You can see that the protein contains a cofactor called flavin adenine dinucleotide, or FAD. This is the group that accepts electrons when succinate is oxidized to fumarate, producing FADH2, or the reduced form of FAD. Now, some textbooks or websites will show FADH2 as a product at this step of the citric acid cycle and not QH2. That's true in that FADH2 is produced, but keep in mind that the electrons of FADH2 are immediately lost to iron sulfur centers in the complex 2 and are ultimately passed to coenzyme Q to make QH2. So FADH2 is only transiently produced, while QH2 is a more long-lived product of the reaction. Note that no protons are moved across the membrane during this process. So, the net reaction is ultimately just a transfer of electrons from succinate to coenzyme Q. The QH2 produced will give its electrons to complex 3 in the Q cycle, as I described in a previous video. We can combine the net reactions of complex 3 and complex 4 to get the net reaction for transfer of electrons from QH2 to oxygen. When we do that, we see that the oxidation of two QH2 molecules allows transport of 12 protons from the matrix to the intermembrane space. Or oxidation of one QH2 allows movement of 6 protons. This is also a number I expect you to know for the exam. So, to summarize electron transport, electrons from NADH and from succinate pass through complexes 1 and 2 respectively to reduce coenzyme Q. From there, electrons pass through complexes 3 and 4, ultimately being added to oxygen to produce water. Electrons are transferred from one group to the next in a defined sequence. The energy from this process is used to create a proton gradient across the inner mitochondrial membrane, with NADH allowing pumping of more protons than QH2. In the next videos, I will describe how the electrochemical gradient created by the electron transport chain is used to synthesize ATP.